that was attached to his knee.
My God.
Means that this could be anybody. Because this is the reality that God has placed for the believer. I want to flip this text up a little bit. I want to show you some stuff because I have a problem with the way that they preach this message. I'm going to be honest with you. I really have a problem with it. What if God says, watch this, I'm going to help you. And there was a certain beggar named Lazarus, which was laid at his gate and full with sores. Now, many of us, we celebrate with Lazarus because Lazarus made it into the bosom of Abraham. Lazarus made it into eternity. Here's the query that I seriously want to give to the church. This was not the call of God on Lazarus' life. Nowhere in the Bible does it suggest to me nor you that this was the way that God wanted Lazarus to feel. Oh man, somebody, it's like gonna make somebody mad here. Bible says that there was a certain beggar and he chose to name him. He chose to identify him because as far as kingdom status quo is concerned, beggars are in the minute portion of the ratio status quo. Oh God. It means that you're not supposed to be a beggar. You're not supposed to live in poverty, in lack, in wantonness. You're not supposed to live with anxiety. But because Lazarus did not manifest the full potential of the value of his purpose, here in the earth realm, he finds himself at a certain rich man's gate. This is not a text of holiness and righteousness. Watch this. This is the text of economic status quo and where it is that you should be in this life. Lazarus was supposed to be the one who was clothed in purple. Purple is a color of royalty. I feel like preaching to somebody. Lazarus was supposed to be the one that was in fine linen, but because of Lazarus' inability to begin to identify with the very call of God on his life, he found himself dealing with hell here in the earth. And it's a few of you, the great God, you may not go to hell, but the problem is every day you wake up, you got to deal with hell. You're living in hell because you're not manifesting the call of God on your life. You're not taking authority. You're not walking in dominion. Your life is not characterized by liberty. And so what God did is he gave you a foreshadow. He gave you a foreglimpse of hell. Here in the terra firma. Here in the earth realm. And what he did was put the weight of hell upon you. And now you're beset. And now you're going back as opposed to moving forward. And you're making a bunch of nonsense, physical noise. But you're waiting to cross onto Chile Jordan. But my soul is right. But you're living in hell. And ain't nobody wanna follow you. Ain't nobody wanna take away from you. Wanna stand with you. Because nobody likes broke.
My God.
I have a problem with Lazarus in this text. Because Lazarus is not maximizing the full call and purpose of God